This video explains how to use CRP5 to calculate true airspeed below 300 knots, and we are starting right now. Hello and welcome to Answering ATPL. The focus of this channel is to provide solutions for EASA ATPL questions and other aviation related stuff. Let me know in the comments section below if you are currently taking ATPL theoretical examination. This video is the seventh video of a series of videos explaining the usage of CRP5 computer face. If this is your first time here, consider subscribing to my channel, and click on the bell icon to get notified when I published a new video. The airspeed indicator is measuring the dynamic pressure, not speed. When corrected for instrument error and position error, it gives us calibrated airspeed or CAS. Calibrated airspeed is also known as rectified airspeed or RAS. For this video, I will use the term calibrated airspeed from now on. When corrected for density error, calibrated airspeed will give us true airspeed or TAS. The relationship between true airspeed and calibrated airspeed is that CAS equals TAS multiplied by the square root of relative density. There are no aircraft instruments that measure air density. However, according to gas laws, pressure, temperature, and density are interrelated. If we know any two of them, we can find the third. Pressure can be obtained through altimeter and temperature from the outside air temperature probe. The navigation computer converts these into the square root of the relative density and thereby convert calibrated airspeed to true airspeed. We will look at an example to make the procedure clear. An aircraft flying at flight level 180 with static air temperature of minus 30 degrees Celsius and calibrated airspeed of 170 knots. Find the true airspeed. In the airspeed window, set flight level 180 or 18,000 feet against the static air temperature of minus 30 degrees Celsius. Find 170 knots calibrated airspeed on the inner scale. Read off the true airspeed on the outer scale opposite to 170 knots calibrated airspeed. Use the cursor to help you read the TAS accurately. The true airspeed is 220 knots. This operation may seem complicated. However, there are several markings on CRP5 that can help you perform this operation. The first marking is the airspeed windows, printed in blue. Underneath it printed in red, that reads to compute TAS from Mach number or RAS or CAS. Then, adjacent to the airspeed window is the label air temperature degrees Celsius and pressure altitude times 1000 feet. By aligning the air temperature and the pressure altitude, we are finding the square root of relative density. On the outer scale, there is a marking in red that read TAS, and on the inner scale, there is a marking in red that read RAS/CAS. These two markings clearly show that the true airspeed is on the outer scale, and the calibrated airspeed is on the inner scale. Now let's look at the second example to solidify our understanding. You are at the flight level 100, the SAT is minus 10 degrees Celsius, and your CAS is 150 knots. What is the TAS? As before in the airspeed window, set the pressure altitude against the static air temperature. In this case, it is flight level 100, or 10,000 feet against minus 10 degrees Celsius. Find 150 knots CAS on the inner scale. Read off the TAS on the outer scale. 173 knots. In the next video in these videos series, we will discuss on true airspeed above 300 knots. If you want to learn more about ATPL or aviation, start now by hitting the round subscribe icons. Also, if you have any questions or comments about ATPL or aviation related problems, you can leave them in the comments section. Thank you so much for watching, I'll see you next time.